I hadn't looked at a flower for about 3 years. Mm. Little simple things like that. I just really got so kind of far away from human things, you know. And I guess because I was brought up in the middle of the countryside in Ireland, in the Golden Vale, in the middle of the fields, I guess that it really affected me badly being so far away from nature and simple things, you know. Whereas I think other celebrities or, you know, famous people who grew up in big cities, when they're used to hotel rooms and they're used to all that kind of man-made stuff, you know.
And that is, of course, the voice of Dolores O'Riordan, the lead singer of the Cranberries, who passed away just last month at the age of 46. The clip is from a forthcoming tribute to Dolores, which will air on RT1 next Monday night at 10:35. The man behind it is Dave Fanning, and he's with me now. Good morning, Dave.
Good morning, Patrick.
Now, what exactly have you done with this?
Well, I'll tell you, it's more of what we haven't done, because this is not, I don't think, the definitive Cranberries documentary that could be made, because it is a pretty phenomenal story, and a story that was massive success around the world. A lot of Irish people in the last few weeks are saying, were they that successful? I mean, were they really that big? And they were. They sold like 22 million of the first two albums alone. And if you think about it, like number three, I'm not going to give you a quiz, Pat, but there is a joint third in terms of success in Ireland. There's a second and there's a first. Obviously, the biggest is U2. Would you know the second?
Enya.
Very good. Enya is number two. A lot of people forget that. 81 million albums. I mean, seriously.
Bring us back to the Cranberries and what happened to them, because Cranberries, they were making a bit of noise here, but suddenly skipped the UK and big in America.
Yeah, and then they became big in the UK because they were big in America. They did skip the UK in so many ways. Yeah, what happened was we used to put them on and down, like we put them on down the gig in Cork Rocks. The lead singer, Dolores O'Riordan, sang with her back to the audience, so scared. Within 18 months, she was playing to 10,000 people in America. It happened very quickly, and it was kind of overnight in some ways. People were looking for something other than what they were told to listen to. And those people, and this is going, I'm not trying to get sexist here, but if you were, say, 13 or 14 to 19, high school in America and female, the Cranberries was your band. They were absolutely huge. She has had a bad last 5 years. This is not about the last 18 years at all. It's just looking back at the 90s, playing some videos and letting her talk. It's her story. The rest of the band do talk too, and they talk about, this is from the earlier days as well, they talk about when Dolores came in first. But like the last 5 years have not been easy, and that's not what the programme is about.